the bad Steve Strong attacking Ricky Martel, Gino, forcing him to the corner. The bell had not rung, and he's laying on the heavy artillery, using those great big arms, 24-inch bicep. And I'll tell you, the forearms aren't small either.
They are not 24-inch pythons, he calls them, but I'll tell you one thing. These two have a grudge. Why? They've made it into a personal grudge. But when you're in the ring with Steve Strong, you have to be determined. There's only a few guys that can rival with Steve Strong, and one of them is Rick Martel, as you well know, Milt. And we should see an epic fight right there between the two.
There's no question of that, and as is obvious to those of you watching in the comfort of your living rooms at home, we're in yet another arena. We're taking you all over the place here on the Gladiators. And talking about gladiators, if you want to define that word as competitors, as fighters, you're looking at two of the toughest in the world right now in the former AWA World Heavyweight Champion, the great Ricky Martel, native son of Quebec City, against the Los Angeles sadistic Steve Strong. And I coined that phrase sadistic, and you know, Gino, to me it's the only word other than arrogant perhaps that absolutely describes this man's mental attitude.
You're right, Mill, and right now is the way Martel is working on Steve Strong, working against the joints. Where are you gonna hurt Steve Strong? Not if you hit him in the chest, the back. You gotta go the knee.
Maybe you have to cut his hair.
I probably, you know.
Well, Delilah did it to Samson.
And it worked, but I doubt it's going to work with Steve Strong. The man is big, he's strong, he knows what he's doing in that ring. And did you see, no matter what Martel does to him, he neutralizes him right away, takes over. Oh, look at this.
Devastating move on the part of Steve Strong. And you know, we all saw the kind of rigorous workout that this man, Steve Strong, does embark upon at all times. One thing you have to say, Martel constantly in the gym working out, Gino. Strong does the very same thing.
Look at it. It goes back to that leg. Now, that's the way to do it.
The mark of a pro.
The mark of a pro. He knows that, you know, everybody's got that Achilles heel. And Steve Strong, it's his knee. A knee is a knee. No matter how many muscles you've got to work on those knees, you take his legs out from under him and the man is finished.
Well, that's true, and one would not be surprised to learn that perhaps Strong does have knee problems after working all those years with the heavy weights.
That's right, doing these heavy squats. Don't you think that kind of hurts the tendons and all that? When you're squatting 800 pounds and working in that gym with that iron all the time, it's got to take a toll on you. Of course, it does make you strong and it gives you endurance, but yes. I mean, he's only human, let's face it, like everybody else.
He may only be human, but right now, he's on the dishing outside of the punishment to Rick Martel. We just saw, after having tossed Martel out of the ring, he took him by the hair, rammed his head into the outside edge of the ring apron. Martel, slow to climb back up to the apron and into the ring. Strong, reaching out through the ropes, grabs Martel by the hair, and follows her onto the apron. Oh no! Ran Martel into that steel post, Gino.
He did. Luckily, Martel ducked out of the way a little bit, and the brunt of the blow was taken on the shoulder. Good thing it wasn't, you know, right on the forehead, because that's not a beer ball there. That's a steel post, and you get hit once on that, and that's it.
Well, there's no question of that, Martel. Oh! Run again, and that time, Gino, the side of his head did catch the steel post.
I don't know if it did. I hope it did, because he really could be held. But no, he's getting up. He's still not finished.
Well,
but look at Strong. He's hurt, Bill.
Yeah,
he's hurt right now. That's why he's getting back into that ring, trying to recover. That leg of his is not in good shape.
He is dishing out tremendous punishment to Martel. You saw him come off the ring apron with the double hammer. He's going to try, yes, suplexing Martel into the ring from the apron outside the ropes. Martel way up high and down heavily. And, well, both of them are not in nearly the shape they were when they entered the ring. Pretty obvious that Martel is somewhat the worse for wear. A little more sore and strong, yet, it seems the adrenaline is starting to flow, starting to course through the veins of Rick Martel. But Strong coming back and laying that big knee stopping him as he's lying there on that bottom rope.
That's right, and I'm wondering right now if Martel, you know, all these bouts he's had against Steve Strong, eventually, if it didn't take its toll, then the man probably is just body tired right now. Because against a man 290 pounds that keeps pounding on you all the time, it's got to hurt, no matter how great a shape you're in.
Well, I can't believe the punishment that each of these two finely tuned, conditioned athletes are dishing out and taking. Oh, my goodness, Gino, how do you withstand the force of a clothesline like we just saw?
By being in great shape, and very few wrestlers are in that type of shape as Rick Martel is. To take a blow like that with those big arms, that big forearm, and keep getting up, because you can see he's still not out. He's hurt, but not out.
Well, he just took the 24-inch python right across the jaw. Now, slammed heavily to the canvas by the big man, 292-pound sadistic Steve Strong, who climbs to the second turnbuckle. Martel flat on his back, ring center, and here comes Strong, but he missed. Martel with a good boom just in the nick of time, and Strong's elbow cut nothing but canvas.
It did, and right now you see how the tide has turned. Not only has he got now a bad knee, a bad elbow, and it's at the joints where it hurts. And now Martel should take advantage of that and keep pounding on. Never mind the people, Martel. Get down to the nitty-gritty, the business of working over Steve Strong.
Well, Martel coming back, stomping out the back of the neck of the big guy, Steve Strong. Grabs him by the hair, lifting him to his feet. He's going to whip him now off the ropes. Whoa, backdrop. Backdrop snapped right over there, and you just saw, folks, how Steve Strong reached back, put his hand in against the small of his back. He's obviously feeling the effects of that backdrop. Yet, had enough in him, Gino Brito, to come back and throw a good right hand punch, cut Martel right in the midsection, and double him over. Martel then fighting back. These guys are reaching down awfully.
Right, because after 10 minutes of hard fighting like that, the pace has to slow down a little bit, and it becomes a question of conditioning. Who's in better condition now, because the blows mean less and less right now?
Well, does it ever get to the point that you almost stop feeling it, that you're just in such constant pain?
It never happened to me. I always felt, especially wrestling guys as big as Steve Strong, when you get hit, you get hurt. I mean, your kidneys hurt, your lower back, the neck, everything hurts.
Your nails, your fingernails.
But you get used to like everything else. You rebound and you try to come back.
Look at the two of them now outside the ring, laying on the lumber each to the other. Did you hear that blow that Martel laid on Strong? They're off, double counted. It's not settled, Gino.
It hasn't been settled in right now, what, 5 or 6 times?
Oh.
No.
Martel's showing that there is no substitute for experience, shoving Strong off, and Strong intending to ram Rick Martel's head into the corner. Turnbuckle was pushed off and cut the corner himself. Folks, I'm going to talk to each of these wrestlers in the dressing room.
Here we are at the replay while Milton's going to the dressing room. This is where we pick up the action. Both men pounding on each other back and forth. Strong throwing Martel outside the ring. Following Martel out, you can see Steve Strong is still has that bad knee. Getting down there, comes down on Martel's back once more. And this is where Steve Strong thought he had it all figured out. This is where they're hitting each other back and forth. What's gonna happen? The big punch comes in. It should be. And another one, it's all over. Let's go to the interview.
Steve Strong, you just wrestled against the great Ricky Martel. You've been chasing him for a long time.
I have beaten that. I took him apart tonight.
Well, disqualification, not really.
The ring.
Is a DQ a satisfactory result for you?
Only if I would have crippled him and put him out of wrestling. I'll tell you, he has the referees on his side. Because when I had him, he was getting beat like a stupid, dumb dog that he is. I mean, what happens? I told you this before. When you start, what do you do with a dog? You train it. You start slapping around, you kick it a few times when it does something wrong. Martel, that's all I've done. I've beaten him. I've kicked him. What does that stupid moron do?
He keeps coming back.
What does that say?
He's a lot of heart.
As sadistic as I am. He's got to be masochistic. I mean, he's crazy. He's a moron. And yet that idiot still wants another rematch.
And are you willing to get into the ring again with him?
Loved this time. I promised the wrestling fans, who all love me, but for obvious reasons, good-looking, muscular, intelligent, something that you're not. And I'm going to tell them. I make this promise. Ricky Martel, you're going to be finished. Wait, where's he from?
Quebec City.
Is that where they want his body sent back, or what are they going to do with
him? I would imagine, yes.
Martel, I'll tell you right now. Mr. Priestman, please, just one thing. Mr. Martel.
Yeah, that lowlife scum of the earth, yeah, what do you want to know about him?
You're being too kind.
You've got no class, no
self-respect. What should I do with him? Should I just put him in a hospital, or?
You should knock out his white, shiny teeth so he can be like the rest of the French Canadians, and they carry him around in the jar.
That's not enough.
Who's this clown beside you?
Both of them.
Well, they plan their strategy for the future. What can I say? That's it in the dressing room at this point, folks. Ricky Martel.